When Naomi has finally announced her divorce from Oni of Ife, it is really sad, but she's the one wearing the shoe. She knows where he's pinching her. Naomi is the third wife of Oni of Ife after he parted ways with first and second wife. She made this news known to the public through her Instagram page. Hi guys, you're watching Mchiki Series. If you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your support. I quite appreciate that. It's good to have you around again. And if you are new to this channel, thank you for clicking on this video. Make yourself comfortable as we get right into this video. Also, hit that red subscribe button and turn your notification bell on. That way you get our latest updates. So, Her Majesty Queen Naomi Ogunwusi took everybody by surprise by announcing her divorce from Oni of Ife through a post on her Instagram page. If you can remember, a lot of blogs have been speculating this, and whenever there is story like this, she comes out to debunk it. She always say, oh, the marriage is fine, people should stop disturbing their marriage, they're so head over heels in love and all those stuff. So people never believe that a day like this will eventually come. Though some people are still skeptical about the marriage because Oni is a traditionalist, the custodian of Yoruba culture, while Naomi is a prophetess. Prior to her marriage, she was in charge of an herald ministry, which is an interdenominational ministry, and it's a big ministry. So a lot of dust were raised when she got married to Oni of Ife, and some people speculated that time that the marriage will not work. But eventually she was able to put in 3 years, and according to her, that she tried to work on her marriage, but she wasn't able to do that. The unfortunate thing is that one person does not work on marriage. For you to work on marriage, it takes two people, two committed people in a marriage to make it work. Anyway, let me read what she wrote on her Instagram handle. It is really sad, but she is the one wearing the shoe. She knows where it pinches. There is no way pretending, like she said, to be in marriage when she knows that there is no marriage. So she said, I bless the Lord Almighty for his faithfulness in the last 3 years of my marriage. It isn't how far, still how well. Indeed, though Satan should be fair if trials should come, I have this blessed assurance controlling all situations and saying to me, it is well with my soul. Certainly it is well. I made my journey into the ancient throne of Ife with faith in my heart and love for the keeper of it. Few impressions I would love to correct. If anyone knows otherwise, they are free to come up with facts. Let it be known that this decision to move on did not come because His Majesty is married to another queen, as many would love to assume. Throughout our life as couple, I was the only married wife to him. There were side attractions, but it was never an issue. I never approached him with any revelation of any sort. There was a time Bloss carried it that she has already divorced with Oni of Ife, and they said that how she got into the palace was that she saw a revelation. She went to the palace herself. She saw a revelation that she is the queen, that the king is going to be married to her, and the rest became history. So she's saying that she never approached him with any revelation of any sort, as many believed. He contacted me first and made his proposal known several months later. The marriage was not arranged one, as many have misconstrued. I never knew the prophetess said to have introduced me to him. Instead, he introduced her to me after I agreed to marry him. I was only being polite out of respect for him. I've never been pregnant all my life before Tade Nikawo. I hope I'm not murdering the name. That's the name of their son. Blunt also carried that she was once pregnant. So she said that she has never been pregnant, and her son is the first ever pregnancy with medical reports to back it up. The girl who is said to be my daughter is my niece. I did my best to endure and make it work many times. That means there has been problem in the palace, like the blogs have been speculating, and she did her best to manage it. She tried to endure so that the marriage will work. She smiled through the struggle, but finally realized that she had one assignment, her son, and when God is done, he is done. He chose Saul to be king. When he was done, he told Prophet Samuel, I have moved on. Religion was never an issue between us. When Oni was about to marry her, some people were saying that why should she get married to the custodian of tradition? How does she think that she'll manage it? But she's saying that religion is not an issue between both of them. Religion was never an issue between us. Please refer to my interview on News Central TV. Instead, His Majesty has a picture he would love the world to see and perceive him as, and another one which is his true self. Okay. Oni of Ife has a picture that he wants the world to see that is not his true self. Maybe that's why he has been having problem with his marriages. He has to look inwards so that he don't paint a picture to the world and go behind closed doors and be another thing. Today, I announce the beginning of a new dawn and the close of a chapter. Today, I'm a mother to God's unique gift. I'm no longer a slave to my thoughts of perfection. I, at this moment, announce that I shall no longer be referred to as wife to Oni of Ife or as queen of Ife, but as queen of the people and mother of my adorable prince, to be continued. Then there's another post that says, he is God's way of saying I know about it all. In situations like this, there will be aggrieved persons. I, at this moment, appeal to all parties involved to allow the peace of God with the consciousness that there is a lovely little boy between us. I thank all of my prayer partners and loved ones. I remain committed to all my projects, charity work, and ministry. In this new season, I shall be focusing on God only. This is a very tough one. This story has been making waves all over the internet. And there was a time Gislova carried this story that she has left the palace before she eventually had her baby. And after, there was still speculation, there were still stories surrounding this. Oni of Ife getting married to another woman and all that. So finally, she's announcing her divorce. She moved on. So this is another letter. The Palace of Oni of Ife released that the Palace of Oni of Ife, Oba Adeyeye Ogunwosi, has described the news shared by Queen Naomi that she has separated from the monarch as untrue. Queen Naomi earlier today, via her Instagram page, announced her separation from the monarch. This is from Oni's Director of Media and Public Affairs, Moses Olafere, in an interview with Vanguard. This is not the first time such rumors have been peddled. There was a time it was reported that she left the palace and the next thing she gave birth. So the story is not true. It should not be taken seriously. Anyway, this is what the media person wrote. I think that they want to do damage control, because when I checked Oni of Ife's Instagram page, they didn't put it up. Like when he had his baby, he made the announcement on his handle. So these ones are trying to do damage control, I guess. Moreover, this is coming from Naomi's Instagram handle,
a verified account for that matter. So some people are also thinking like me, like Victoria Enyama. She said, you should have liars with Lai Mohammed to structure a convenient explanation, or better still, her Instagram was hacked. Oh dear.
At this point, they're trying so hard to control the narrative. It is really sad, but before this happened, some people saw it coming. Being a prophetess and getting married to Oni of Ife, who is the custodian of tradition of Ife Kingdom, and Ife Kingdom is one of the ancient kingdoms, they must have had laid down rules and regulations, which I believe she would have done her assignment to check whether it would be conducive for her as a prophetess to step into the kingdom. That's what she decides for herself. Now that she wants to move on, it is okay. This has gone to show that all that glitters is not gold. Sometimes people want to have a life they've never tested, not knowing that it might not be the best for them, and their money does not solve all problems. Actually, to marry from royal family is not easy. To be royalty, it's not easy. There are so many things you have to condone. There are so many things you have to tolerate, because as a king, he can take other wives, which that one came up. She said she wouldn't mind or something like that. And again, there are concubines. A lot of people have reacted to this, and this lady wrote, she's not cut out for all these traditions and all. Too many queens. What was she thinking? I really feel for her, so young and too fragile for the role she entered in. And this person wrote, all that glitters and gold. I will never use someone else's relationship as a prayer point. This person wrote, that throne of queenship is not for the feeble-minded. And the next comment says, and they said Gislova is fake. Gislova said it few weeks ago, Omasheu. And this one said, gone are the days when women prayed and hoped for marriage to work. Now women don't take nonsense and prefer to love themselves better, with four clapping hands emoji. And this person wrote, this Oni of Ife should check himself. Three wives don't come go. His first wife gone, when war are gone, this one too gone, Oba Eyara Yinwo. And this person said, you wanna chill with someone that eats and dine with the gods, and you're born again Christian, lol. Forget love sometimes, some things can't work. And this person said, this is so bad, she's just too calm. This one pain me, this lady should have just gotten married to one cool-headed brother in her church. I'm not saying Oni is not cool-headed, but she's too calm for royal family. And this person said, oh my God, with three crying emoji, why did Oni allow this? So sad to read the gift of God, make it rich. and added no sorrow. Your son will bring you all the love. God bless you. This is the last comment that he says, it takes a strong mind to move on. Well done, Queen of Hearts. Congratulations on the new era. Grace all the way. 3 hearts, 4 praying hands, 4 balloons, and the celebration. So it's not really easy to be a queen. It's not easy to be a royalty, but sometimes people don't really consider those. They just look at the rosy part of it and they jump right into it after they start seeing the other side of it. By that time, the only way they go about it, either they leave or they stay and close their mouths and suffer in silence. So let me know what you guys think about it. Even Meghan Markle, when she left Buckingham Palace, she also said that she didn't know that royalty is like that. Royal family, there are some things that they forbid. She sees it as a normal family. But before you jump into royal family, you check there are rules and regulations. So you have to make up your mind whether you stay even with that or you want to live your life. So as far as I'm concerned, being royalty, you don't have your life again. You lost your freedom. So let me know what you guys think. I'm gonna sign off here. Stay healthy and safe. Remember to share this video with family and friends. Subscribe to the channel if you're not done already. And I'm gonna catch you guys in my next video. Bye, and remain blessed.